Hello there, my name is Udit. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the partnerships interview that typically comes up in Facebook's technical program manager interview loop. At the end of this video, you should have a pretty good understanding of what to expect in this interview, what your interviewers are looking for, as well as a couple of tips on how to prepare for it. As a quick introduction, I'm from Prepfully. We offer mock interviews with someone who's worked in your target company and role, alongside a host of other interview prep services. So on our website, you can find recorded interviews, interview questions, interview guides, and plenty of other useful stuff. In this context, we've got a bunch of Facebook TPMs who've been helping candidates with both mock interviews and advice. They've put together a lot of helpful content. This video is a good example of it. So, on to the partnership interview then. For those of you who are wondering what this is one of the five interviews that creates Facebook's on-site TPM loop. The others are the technical project retrospective, the architecture and systems design interview, the program sense interview, and the behavioral and leadership interview. Each of these interviews, including the partnerships one, which we'll discuss in a lot more depth, is typically about 45 minutes long. So when it comes to the partnerships interview, in a nutshell, the interviewer is basically focusing on your ability to collaborate with key stakeholders and demonstrably drive progress. Specifically, we can break the themes that you're going to be assessed on into five key buckets. The first is bridging the gap. So this is all about your ability to bridge the gap between technical and non-technical stakeholders. So for instance, compliance and legal. It could also be around ensuring non-technical considerations are factored into technical decisions, such as architectural designs and deployment schedules. So a sample question here could be, how do you translate requirements usually for engineering teams? The second bucket you're assessed on is your ability to align and prioritize. So how do you build relationships with cross-functional stakeholders and drive alignment when teams potentially have conflicting priorities? There could also be situational questions here around how you would or how you previously achieved buy-in from important stakeholders who might have at that point been opposed to your ideas. For this kind of question, it's really useful to keep track of Facebook's core values and map some of your answers to them. So move fast, be bold, focus on impact, be open, build social values. These often provide the basis for establishing guiding principles, which you could then use to drive alignment. Questions here can be pretty direct. You could get questions like, tell me about a time you got buy-in from peers who were initially resistant to your idea, or tell me about how you kept stakeholders up to date for a project you were driving. The third bucket then is your ability to unblock progress. So make sure you have examples of when you've previously isolated bottlenecks in initiatives you were driving, how you diagnosed issues, what steps you took or what steps you would take to troubleshoot problems with different teams or people involved. So here's a sample question here. Tell me about a time a resource from another team didn't want to work on your project after having committed to it. The fourth thing you're assessed on then is your ability to adapt. Let's take an example. Legals raised several concerns a week before you launch a brand new ranking for the Facebook newsfeed. What are you going to do now? What are some of the actions you could take? Or let's take another example. The data engineering supporting your team has suddenly got pulled away to deal with an urgent compliance issue. How are you going to adapt to this scenario? Finally, a key component you're also evaluated on is your personal communication style. So that's really important for this particular interview. Make sure your stories are succinct, get to the point quickly, demonstrate your competence, demonstrate your learnings, but make sure you leave sufficient room for your interview or to explore follow-ups in much more depth. So that's all from me then. This is our guidance from Prepfully on how to do a great job in the Facebook TPM partnerships interview. Once you feel ready for some practice, or if you just want a sense check of how ready you are, you can book an anonymous partnership style mock interview with a Facebook TPM on Prepfully. There's a link in the description below. In addition, we've also linked to a bunch of useful resources for the Facebook TPM interview. There's a guide which goes into much more depth than I have in this interview. There's also lots of sample interview questions, not just for the partnerships interview, but for all the other interview types. So feel free to check those out. If you have any follow-up questions about this particular interview, please feel free to ask in the comments before. And if you like the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks and good luck for your interview.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.